स्टूडेंट्स, अवर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज फॉर्मेशन एंड रीऑर्गेनाइजेशन ऑफ इंडियन स्टेट. ओके, आफ्टर जॉइनिंग ऑल दिस प्रिंसली स्टेट एंड सम यूनियन टेरिटरीज विच इज अंडर कंट्रोल ऑफ फ्रेंच एंड पोर्टुगीज गवर्नमेंट, इंडियन गवर्नमेंट स्टार्टेड रीऑर्गेनाइजेशन एंड फॉर्मेशन ऑफ ऑल दिस इंडियन स्टेट्स. ओके, सो India became independent and acquired information about unification of princely state. Okay. After India attaining or joining or merge all these union territories and princely state, they get all information because of unification of princely state. Instead of accepting unitary system, we had accepted union system of governance. Okay, what is the difference between these two words, unitary system and a union system? Unitary means all these administrations were run through the one government, union or central government. But in the union system, there is a union government at the central level and all the states and local government at the different level. And this, for following this union system, administration would be very easy. Therefore, the issue of formation and reorganization of constituents of the union occurred. Okay, because of the following of this system, the formation and reorganization of constituents of the India or union occurred. For temporary basis, British provinces and all the princely states were divided into four divisions. Okay. Which of the four? Class A, Class B, Class C and Class D. In Class A, there is some major economical provinces like Mumbai, Assam, Andhra, Punjab, UP, Bihar, Madras, Orissa, West Bengal were included. While in Class B, Jammu, Kashmir, Hyderabad, Mysore, Central India, Rajasthan, Saurashtra, Travancore, Cochin and Pepsu. Pepsu means Patiala and East Punjab states of Union. In Class C, they included Ajmer, Bhopal, Coorg, Delhi, Bilaspur, Kutch, Himachal Pradesh, Tripura, Manipur and Vindhya Pradesh. Vindhya means today it is known as Madhya Pradesh. Classification of states D. In this D classification, only Andaman and Nicobar Island were included. Okay. Interestingly, today we considered all the states have given all the rights and give equality and freedom to all the state. But today, at that time, the classification was made with the four classes didn't give equal status. However, they were inseparable part of India. Okay, because like today, okay, any country or any territory outside of India can join to India. Okay, but any country from India is not going to outside. In this way, when the Constitution of India came into force, India was the union of this state. Okay? India is the today, it is also union of this whole state, and this is the only temporary arrangement. Okay. But after that, new demand of linguistic basis arrangement, linguistic based arrangement was started. In 1953, Jawaharlal Nehru considered the issue of reorganization of states and appointed state reorganization commission. Okay. What was the demand for reorganization of state on the basis of a language? Okay. Started for considering that problem in 1953, Jawaharlal Nehru appointed state reorganization commission. Three members included in this: retired Chief Justice of India or Supreme Court Judge Justice Fazal Ali was the chairman, and other two members, Adinath Kunjru and K.M. Panikkar was the other two member in this. And commission also asked all the state to submit its recommendation through various public opinion. Okay, all the states have to give their voting or opinion through public voting. And above all, first problem was occurred in Andhra Pradesh, then and after second was a bilingual Mumbai state, means bilingual means at that time the two language were spoken in Mumbai. First is a Marathi and second was a Gujarati, and it include Maharashtra, Gujarat and Saurashtra. Okay, and the Mumbai was the capital city of that time of the bilingual Mumbai. Okay, and after that some changes were made in constitution and reorganizing state was passed and implemented from 1956. Okay, after that some changes were made in constitution and old classification of states, like we have seen that class A, class B, class C and class D was dissolved, and as per the Indian constitution two parts of this states and union territories were framed. First is a only constituent states and second is a union territory. Okay, in these 14 states include Andhra Pradesh, Assam, Bihar, Mumbai, Jammu Kashmir, Kerala, Madhya Pradesh, Madras, Mysore, Orissa, Punjab, Rajasthan, UP, West Bengal, while in UT union territories Delhi, Himachal Pradesh, Manipur, Tripura, Andaman and Lakshadweep were included. Okay, finally central government made two separate states. Okay, on the demand, on the basis of demand of early bilingual states, Maharashtra and Gujarat. Gujarat was established on May 1, 1946, and every year this first May is considered to be the Gujarat Establishment Day. Okay, Assam, Meghalaya, Manipur, Tripura, Arunachal Pradesh, Mizoram and Nagaland were reorganized as a land of seven sisters. Today we are considered these old states as a seven sisters. Then after demand for the formation of the states on the basis of language was started in the year 2000s, Jharkhand was separated from Bihar, Chhattisgarh was separated from Madhya Pradesh, Uttarakhand was separated from UP. Okay, and lastly in 2014 Telangana was separated from Andhra Pradesh, and today some various demand for the separation like Vidarbha regions of Maharashtra. Okay, Vidarbha region of Maharashtra, because very isolated place from Maharashtra, and they demand different state which is joined with the Maharashtra. Currently union exists 28 state. Okay, here written in 7 union territory and 1 national capital Delhi. Okay, next, some problem is given here is, first is a regionalism. Okay, India has a unity in diversity, we all know that, and the people which is following a diverse religion, also speaking different languages, which belong to different caste, races and culture, have been living since many centuries. Okay, and no other countries have a diversity seen like India have. All the cultural progress is also associated with a particular caste or creed, but it's a unified effort of people living in India. Okay, any cultural progress is not associated with any caste or religion. Okay, but how the people living with a unity in diversity, that is a matter, and it is also make a progress for the cultural development. Okay, next, one of the main reason for creating the feeling of regionalism and certain greedy politicians, okay, who created all these types of regionalism. So politicians, various communal groups, okay, who exploit the feeling of people for their own purpose, The people who create and instigate regionalism and harmful elements for national unity and integrity, okay, the aspiration for personal development is good thought. Okay. Everyone has to right to develop, but the aspiration for your only your greedy and lure motive is not good for the society and it creates a regionalism. Okay. But the one who poses danger to the society at large never aspire for overall development of a country. Activities harming one's own state and country should not be done. Okay. We have discussed that after regionalism, okay, because of the regionalism, this also affects the state and also a country. Instead, working for one's own country is necessary, not for the separate country, one's own country is necessary. After achieving independence, the thought for one's own country should come first instead of state. Okay. After getting independence, okay, one should have a thought for their own country, not for their own state. Okay. Here written that it becomes very obvious for people speaking common language, sharing common culture and living in certain specific geographical region for a long time, okay, how this problem of regionalism is created, because the people living in this particular area have some common language and also share some common culture and also live in a certain geographical region, and these three main factors is important, then that leads to the regionalism. Now on the basis of a language also create a regionalism. Okay, people mostly Hindi speaking are seen in the North India and non-Hindi speaking in the South India. Okay. They demanded their new regions according to their language. We have discussed lastly in 2014 Telangana was separated from Andhra Pradesh on the basis of their particular language. Okay. And the state's reorganization commission already implemented the recommendation of division of regions as per the linguistic barriers. Okay. So state reorganization commission also declared this as a not good, and they also deciphered this state reorganization commission all the states demand. Okay. Now last is a caste and religion. People belonging to different religions live in India. Superiority of one particular religion exists in certain region. Here written that superiority means the people of Nagaland, Mizoram, Manipur, Arunachal Pradesh have a different customs, tradition, lifestyle and profession. So here written that Bodo people means the people have a superiority, means the one caste have a superiority also demanded different region according to their language. Okay. Ulfa is also active in Assam, Punjab, Haryana, separated because of regionalism. Okay, Punjab and Haryana is a quite similar language, but minor different is there, so that's why Punjab and Haryana also separated. In the same way, Jharkhand separated from Bihar, Chhattisgarh. Okay, Jharkhand is separated from Bihar, Chhattisgarh from Madhya Pradesh, and Uttarakhand from Uttar Pradesh. Currently, the demand for a separate Vidarbha region from Maharashtra has been going on. We have already discussed on the basis of all this. Okay. This is okay. Sometimes there is some demand is occurred on the basis of the language, caste and religion. But one should have to focus on for a country, not for the state. Now is a regional inequality. Regional inequality. Okay. In previous topic we have discussed about regionalism. now regional inequality. So the foreign rulers didn't undertake development activity, okay, foreign didn't do any economic activity where they didn't get any profit, okay, jahan pe profit nahi wahan pe kuch kaam hi nahi kiya. As a result, there was a regional inequality in such place. Regional means in terms of money. Okay. After independence, the planning commission was formed for social and economic development of India. The planning commission formed for the, this planning commission only think tank, and they gave some suggestions for the development of India, only economic perspective. One of its main aim is to development of a different religion like Bihar, Odisha, okay, because Britishers didn't get any profit from this area, so they didn't do any development in this particular area. So government has to focus on this region. In fact, regional pressure, certain political reasons, the tug of war to take development program to their own religion, okay. Some political leader came from the particular area, so they developed their area because of the vote bank. And other factor played an important role in it. Therefore, regional inequality is seen in matter of equal development, and resource of development grants given are the factor. Okay. Resource development first thing, and the grant which is given by government to the state, central government to the state, is the reason behind regional inequality. Even within developed, moderately developed or less developed state, internal inequality exists considerably. Okay, there are three types of state. First is a developed like Gujarat, second moderately developed, and third is a less developed state are there. For example, Maharashtra is in category of economically developed state because it is the capital of India, economic capital of India. But its regions, like we have discussed, Vidarbha is demands separate demand from Maharashtra because they not get enough resources from Maharashtra government and also some isolated region. So Maharashtra is considered economically developed state, but their regions like Vidarbha and Marathawada are backward. Certain area of Andhra Pradesh are well developed. Why? While some their own area, Andhra Pradesh, Rayalaseema and Telangana are considerably backward. Now Telangana has started gaining economic profit because Hyderabad is included in Telangana. That's why some regions are ahead in agricultural development, while some is ahead in industrial development. Okay. There are so many factors between the states and the central that leads to the regional inequality. Okay. And there are also some boundary problem and river water issues also there, okay, like Maharashtra, Karnataka, Punjab and Haryana boundary issue are still there, okay. Narrow mindedness can be seen of politician because of this flow of water. We have discussed that river water problem, minerals, industrial raw materials. And agriculture sector. Okay, this regional inequality and narrow-mindedness is tremendously harmful for the unity of the country. Means we have to preserve dignity and superior position for the economic development. Next is the scientific and technological development. After getting independence, we have today we are among the topmost country of a developed country in which we have achieved a good science and technological development. We have a good literacy rate, okay, and after that India's growth in the field of science and technology in comparison with other countries is unique. Many national leaders and scientists like Homi Bhabha, Raja Ramanna, Vikram Sarabhai, C.V. Raman in space technology, all in engineering, M. Viswasraya, Sam Pitroda, APJ Kalam, Abdul Kalam, India's former president and the creator of a successful metro railway project, E. Sridharan, are of those engineers, scientists and technocrats which tremendously contribute in the field of science and technology. Okay, Indian Institutes of Science IISc, Indian Institutes of Technology IIT, Indian Space Research Organization ISRO, and PRL Physical Research Laboratory are the glorious examples. Okay, women are also played important role, and this is also given in this list. Janaki Amma, field flora vegetation. Azim Chatterjee, chemistry. Indira Ahuja, medicine. Shakuntala Devi, mathematician and human computer. Today the picture is also made on this woman. Kalpana Chawla is a astronaut. Here some scenario is given. At the time of our independence, we were dependent on others for good food, grains. Okay, and the country which is totally not dependent for their own food, so they have to import food grains from the other countries, and which is very difficult or danger for their economy. Here written this: when we got a independence, we are not dependent on the food grains. Okay, we are not developed enough amount of food grains. In making us self-reliant in this area, today huge dams, lakes and canals have played a major role. Okay, making self-reliant in this area, so huge dams, lakes and canals have played a major role. We have been making use of modern agricultural technology to increase agriculture production. Today we have totally changed and we made a total agriculture independence. Okay, and today we also export some things to the other countries, mostly rice and wheat. We have been able to achieve green revolution. Okay, in 1960-70 eras, mostly they focused upon the wheat and rice, and after that agriculture institutions, laboratories and agriculture university have been established to achieve all this type of agriculture growth. Okay, India has also make a significant headway in nuclear science and technology. Also today we are making small pins to the gigantic material, and also hydrogen bomb, atomic bomb. Also India has established some research institution laboratory for the purpose of research in nuclear power. Nuclear scientists and engineers have constructed ultra modern nuclear reactors. Okay, nuclear reactor is also developed, and power station. By successfully conducting nuclear test twice at Pokhran in Rajasthan, we have been successful in making nuclear bombs. Today we are also making a nuclear bomb also. In space technology, we have achieved this research space technology in very small time, very good name. We have developed a space shuttles. Space shuttle means the which carry any satellites and put them in their respective orbit. So it is called as a vehicle for the satellite. Is two types, GSLV and second is a PSLV. Vehicles are there. GSLV is a geosynchronous satellite launch vehicle, and PSLV is polar satellite launch vehicle. Okay, GSLV is useful for a heavy satellite like a 4000 to 5000 kilo, and PSLV is useful for 1000 to 1500 kilograms satellite. Okay, so GSLV to launch satellite in their outer space. We also launched them satellite like Aryabhatta, mathematician, great mathematician. After their name, India launched their first satellite on the name of Aryabhatta, Bhaskar, Rohini. These all are useful in successfully conducting nuclear test, telecasting, education, weather, getting import information about minerals through remote sensing system. In last one decade, we have also made a significant progress in the field of this space technology: telecommunication, internet, mobile, computer, smartphone, tablet, fax, email, Twitter and computer. Today India is also developed some application which is developed in India only, and India is considered in the race of developed nation, from developing to developed nation race. Okay, last paragraph. In the biotechnology or in the industries field, energy, agriculture, health, all this field is a basic field of Indian economy, and research and development in this field is carried out. And today India is also developed Digital India and Make in India. Today it is a very world famous. Marine research and continuous development, human resource also have developed. Harbor development, including education and health sector, are two continuously involved. Okay. 21st June, which proposed India United Council to celebrate as a World Yoga Day, because it is the longest day in topic of cancer region. So that's why India proposed this plan to celebrate 21st June as a World Yoga Day in United Nation. And after all, this nation is propose and accept this plan, and which shows the growing future of India. So we have studied regionalism and regional inequality, and the development of some space in other technologies. So this is the end of our video. I hope it is very clear to you all.